If you want to get in contact with me, the best way to do it is on Instagram. If you just want to say what up, if you want to tell me you love my videos, you can tell me that you hate my videos, but the best way to do that is on Instagram. Peace, y'all. Johnny Fastlane here. So, Kanye West becomes hip-hop's newest billionaire, and Travis Scott and Kid Cudi drop the Scots. Plus, over 12 million people watch Travis Scott's concert on Fortnite. Let's talk hip-hop.
All of these shoes are inside of every single shoe. It all flows through. Everything flows into everything.
All right, so Kanye West is now hip-hop's newest billionaire, right? And it's crazy because, all right, Forbes, they just dropped like an article. They made like this whole announcement or whatever, and they're basically breaking down why Kanye West is a billionaire, right? So, you know, at first they reported on Kanye West. They said that he wasn't a billionaire yet. I guess he knows somebody up there at Forbes because he sent them a text message like, yo, I'm a billionaire. Y'all need to relook at it again. How are you going to say Kylie Jenner is a billionaire but not me? Is it because I'm black? So on and so forth, right? So anyway, they asked Kanye West for more financial records, and after reviewing those records, they determined that Kanye West is a billionaire in fact, right? But a lot of his money is coming from his Yeezys brand, right? So, all right, this is the way that kind of Forbes broke it down, right? So they determined that Kanye West does own 100% of Yeezys, right? Even though Yeezys right now is caught up in litigation with Adidas, and basically Adidas and Yeezy have partnered at least for the next 5 years, right? So what that means is, and it's because, you know, Adidas, they distribute, they advertise, and they put together the shoe itself, right? So of course they're gonna make most of the money from it, right? Kanye West gets 15% of the profits of his Yeezys, right? And even though it's only 15%, it still amounts to a whole bunch of money. So last year in 2019, Kanye West made $140 million liquid cash just off of his share in Adidas, that 15%, right? And because of all of that, they determined that his net worth is $1.4 billion because he made $1.4 million last year on just the Yeezys itself, right? Not to mention houses that he owns, you know, more than one. Not to mention his rich millionaire spouse, right? Not to mention jewelry that he has that might be worth over $1 million, other businesses that he has, his cars that he has, and, you know, a lot of other stuff. So because of royalties, streaming, residuals, all of that. So all of that stuff coupled into just the fact that, I mean, Kanye West is not just a nigga that makes sneakers, right? If Kanye West was a nigga that makes sneakers, still his net worth would be $1.2 billion right now just off of that. But because of everything else too, he's definitely worth more than a billion, right? Well over $1 billion, right? Which is insane. Probably like 1.5 or 1.6 billion actually, right? Which is crazy. But the next, you know, billionaire in hip hop is probably going to be Rihanna, because it seems like, you know, rappers and, you know, other people are making way more money off of other ventures that's not music, right? Music is cool, but Jay-Z got his billions off of working with Ace of Spades, right? You know, music is cool, but Kylie Jenner got her billions off of, you know, her makeup line, right? And I think that Rihanna, with this whole Fenty shit and the Puma shit, is going to be the next billionaire, right? But we will see, right? Let me know what y'all think about this in the comments.
Should we play some more new shit?
Waiting for
what?
Should we play some more new shit?
Oh, you want to play some more new shit?
Think we should play.
Crap, let's get it, man. Whatever you want.
All right, I can't play too much of that clip for copyright reasons, right? But you see, so Travis Scott goes on his live, and then Kid Cudi joins him, and then Travis Scott and Kid Cudi are both playing like new music on Travis Scott's live, right? And this is crazy because Kid Cudi and Travis Scott, they've, you know, worked together a little bit before, but Travis Scott has said, you know, numerous times that Kid Cudi is somebody that he looks up to, right? Kid Cudi is a dope ass artist that he used to listen to when he was growing up. He said that Kid Cudi actually, you know, didn't know it, but stopped him from doing a lot of, you know, bad stuff to himself, to Travis Scott, to himself, right? I guess maybe Travis Scott was depressed when he was growing up or whatever, and he used Kid Cudi's music to get him through that, right? He also says that Kid Cudi is such a huge musical influence for him, right? And it's crazy because, you know, Travis Scott and Kid Cudi, they do have a song together that came came out like back in 2016, I think it's called Through the Late Night or whatever like that, where Travis Scott in the second verse, he basically kind of like uses Kid Cudi's whole flow from Day and Night, which is actually pretty fire, right? So the whole situation is they're up on live, they're showing new music, but this comes, you know, right after Travis Scott premieres another, a second song with him and Kid Cudi on Fortnite, right? Called The Scots, right? And also then it came out on Spotify right after that too. And this is during Travis Scott's, you know, huge epic, you know, performance on Fortnite, right? And this shit is crazy. So, you know, he's performing Sicko Mode. He's performing, you know, a whole bunch of stuff that we all know and love from Travis Scott. But then when they dropped this song, The Scots, nobody ever heard it. And I'm telling you right now, people on Fortnite went crazy, right? I mean, we're quarantining. And I don't know if that's the reason why, you know, over 12 billion people were on Travis Scott's live stream. But it is insane how many people, 12 million, not 12 billion, but it is insane how many people were on it, right? Now, the song The Scots is fire, right? I mean, this little clip that they put on Instagram, this song is fire too, and it seems like it's more rappy and not so, I guess, sing-songy, I guess, like how that other song with Travis Scott and Kid Cudi was like years ago, right? But either way, every song that Travis Scott and Kid Cudi have come out with, to me, has been super fire. And the fact that, you know, both of them have more than one song that came out on the same day together, right after Travis Scott did his epic performance on Fortnite, kind of tells me that maybe, you know, Travis Scott and Kid Cudi are going to come out with a whole album together, and that this is like the beginning of that, right? And that their name of their group is going to be called The Scots, right? And it's kind of dope because Travis Scott actually took Kid Cudi's first name, because Kid Cudi's first real name is Scott. So he used that for his rap name and calls himself Travis Scott, right? So it's dope for, I guess, like a Travis Scott to like work with somebody that he's looked up to throughout his whole life, right? And you know how they say, you should never meet your heroes because you may be disappointed and find out that they're really not how you thought they were. But it seems pretty dope and cool that Travis Scott met one of his musical heroes, and that it seems like they're getting along, and that that Kid Cudi lived up to everything that Travis Scott thought Kid Cudi would be, right? Which is all dope, right? Plus Kid Cudi's a legend out here in these streets, right? But anyway, let me know what y'all think about this and everything else in the comments down below. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe. Make sure you hit that notification bell. Follow me at Johnny Fasten on Instagram, and y'all already know what to do. Peace.